Good morning, welcome back to my channel. My name is David. I started cleaning my closet, organizing my stuff over here in my tool room. So here is, I started putting stuff in there. That top one, all that stuff's gotta come out because I gotta vacuum the inside, then I'm gonna put all that stuff back. And then as you can see here, I've already started putting my stuff away here. A little bit at a time. I organized all my precision screws, as you can see, all in bins. And then I have a label maker that I'm going to use to label them so I know what type of screws are in there, like, you know, fine threads, specialty screws for certain jobs. Here's some like strange miscellaneous stuff here. Also, I have one small box here. All right, so if you look here, this is all remnants of furniture that I've put together. Furniture similar to something like IKEA, where they have all the stupid like tightening and special screws, and where you would install and then it would kind of like grab a hold of like this piece here. So what I did is I kept all of these extra parts that I did not use. Like for instance, this thing here, it's actually designed to be covering like a screw head. So I have tons of these things that I've kept. So something like that, when I store it, I'm gonna store it and then I'll just label the side here with my label printer. I'm gonna end up taking this bench out, putting it out there with where it belongs. So what I did was I plugged this in. If you guys remember my last video, one of my videos that I passed a week or so, I bought this on eBay. And so what I did was I plugged it in and I filled it with water. It probably got about a half a gallon of water in here. The thing with this type of pipe, this half inch, it just literally guzzled all the water I put in it. So I got it plugged in, hot wired to the wall with this 12 volt 1 amp. And it's keeping up pretty good. It sounds loud because it's sitting on top of this, but once I pick it up, you don't hear as much vibration. It's actually working really good. And with all the bubbles that were in it, I saw how much it flows. I mean, this freaking thing can go. So I'm assuming that once I plug it to the computer, it's probably gonna have a little bit more power. Because this is only 1 amp. So I'm not sure how many amps it throws up, but I think it might be more than 1 amp on the power supply for the PC. This will go in my media box that I have, where I'm gonna have like my thermostat and everything like that. And then these hoses will go to the CPU block, and then after that it's gonna end up going to the radiator that I have, the car radiator, which is gonna be interesting to see, because I feel that with a radiator that big and able to mount it somewhere professionally looking and a few fans on it, I think that's gonna make a huge difference. I'm actually, so here's the car radiator that I bought. I've had this because I had this vision in my mind where I wanted to create like a big water cooling block that would really perform absolutely different than anybody else. So obviously, I have never seen anybody. I personally haven't. If you have, let me know. But I have never seen anybody ever use a car radiator for cooling their computer. So as you can see, it's very thin. It's not that thick at all. And I feel that I could literally build this in to something like around and just keep these fins available, right? Like what I wanna mount this to the wall underneath my table, someplace where it won't look ridiculous. I wanna buy the radiator fan that actually goes with this. And since that runs on 12 volts, I can plug that directly to my computer. And it doesn't even have to blow like crazy. It just needs to blow enough where it will help cool this off. And with something this big, there is no way in hell that I cannot get good performance out of that. So as you can see, we have this here and we have this here. So I'm not really sure what's what, because when I look in here, I see a hole and then I see this thing and then I see another one down there. So, and I'm sure this is to fill it. This right here. I'm sure that's to fill it. So there's a bunch of like in and outs in here. So I gotta really figure out what's what, but when I bought it, I was really happy with the form factor of it. And something like this should be easy to mount. I mean, you got these holes already pre-drilled here, all right? So you make something custom that can actually be mounted against the wall. The fan can be on this side and it'll blow the air through here. And at the same time, it'll heat up my room in the winter time. So it's not like it'll be bad. And the fan can be tweaked to the point where it can be very quiet. Not like the car radiator. When you're in the car, you hear the fan come on and it's like so loud. So this thing can actually be tweaked so it can run, you know, quiet. But I feel like this is a great option. So what I've been doing is I've been messing around with that radiator that I bought, that all-in-one. I spent $100 on it. So what I'm thinking about doing is actually throwing it back in the box and just sending it back. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna run this. As long as I use half inch, I think I'm gonna be perfectly fine. What I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna look for the fan that perfectly mounts on this, that's designed for this, and it's only gonna be about maybe 2.5, 2 inches, and so it'll be a nice form factor. And then I'll make a mount that can mount to the back of this, then mount to the wall, so there's a little bit of room for the fan to suck air through. Problem is, if I put this part, or wherever the fan is blowing through, up against the wall, what's gonna happen is it's gonna fill the back of the wall filled with like dust and debris and stuff. So I'd rather have it facing out so I can actually clean it. So that was my plan for a while now, is just to use a car radiator. I was debating when I was gonna start that project. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm gonna put together my system now, the one I'm using. I'm gonna work on this, perfect it, then I'm gonna embed it into my system after. But I like the fact that this is all in one. And then when I put the LED in here, from the back of this, I can actually see what's going on from the back. So that's cool too. But yeah, this freaking thing, man, guzzles a lot of water. I have a job interview today, so I took the day off. I had like a shitload of personal time. I don't even understand how. I was only working for like 4 weeks, and I already got like 24 hours of personal time. So it's unbelievable. It's so weird. I'm just not used to being treated like that. That's why it's like. And then I looked at my check from last week. Now I got 40 hours personal time. So I'm like absolutely like blown away. I don't understand. So I'm gonna go on a job interview. This one's gonna have more responsibility, and it pays more than the one I have now. Which is, I just can't get over the fact of like how blind I have been for so many years. In my last place, I was there for so long and I made like shit for money compared to what I'm making now. And when I got this last job, I had 3 jobs offering me just about like within a couple $1,000 apart from each other per year. Like I just couldn't believe it. I was so blind. It's just so blind. I was so faithful to my last company. I worked so hard thinking I was gonna move somewhere and I didn't go anywhere. It's just such a shame that I wasted so many of my years there. The good thing is at least I took the responsibility with me, so I knew how to do what I do, and as long as I keep my dedication. But it's just so sad that companies prefer, you know, paying nothing and just instead of having loyalty from their employees. It's so sad, man. So I was very loyal, but man, was I blind or what? Talk about living in a box, man. Now fuck their beats. As soon as I left, I realized how much I should have been making. Me and my family could have been taking vacations in peace without worrying about any types of manipulations when we got back. I mean, it's such a hostile environment. I feel so bad about that everybody like that's still there. Just, I can't even explain how bad I feel. I wish I could take them all with me. So anyways, I get that job interview today. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shave, cut my hair a little bit. So I'm gonna go and I just wanna have a clean shave. I don't wanna go there with stubs hanging out, you know what I mean? Doesn't look great. Doesn't look very professional, so. So that's my plan for today. So that's why I look this rough. It's just I wanna have a clean shave. I was waiting for this for a couple days, so. So anyways, that's why I'm home. It's so boring. I'm used to so much chaos and like action, and like over there it's just like, you know, you're only watching over like 5 people. I'm not used to that. And this one here is gonna be like close to 20, so that's good. And it's closer to home and more money. I'm gonna go return my AIO because I'm going to just do 100% water cooling. I just wanna, before I leave, I wanna tell you guys who my favorite YouTuber is. My favorite YouTuber, if it matters to anybody besides myself. Hey Google. Turn the volume up to 8 and give me a drum roll. Linus Tech Tips. That's who my favorite one is. That's who I watch the most. That's who I actually get excited for every time I see a video posted. He's the best. He's awesome. And congratulations, buddy. You're you seem like a real nice person. Like, you don't look like a piece of shit asshole that has too much money. You actually look like a really good person. So don't forget to wish me happy birthday in the comments, or tell me go F you or something, okay? Alright, I'll see you guys later. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to be kind to each other.